Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspentech Channel, and in our today's problem statement, we will be solving or we will be producing a flow sheet to produce ethyl chloride from ethylene and hydrogen chloride. So this is the overall process flow sheet to produce ethyl chloride, and it starts from the stream number 1, which is the feed stream, which contains mainly ethylene and HCl with small traces of nitrogen. Then it is sent to this conversion reactor. We are assuming a conversion reactor to make it simpler. However, once we talk about its rigorous kinetics, then obviously we have to use PFR or CSTR type reactors. The vapor from this reactor is compressed to a high pressure. Obviously, in that regard, the temperature also increases, which is cooled down and is then sent to this separator. And as a result of separation, the streams number 7 and 8 are produced. The 7 number stream is sent to this distillation column. This number 10 streams contain pure ethyl chloride, while the number 9 and number 8 streams are mixed. Then they are split. Part of it is purged, while the remaining part is recycled. How it is recycled? By first passing through a valve. The pressure is let down, then is heated to that of the temperature as that of the feed temperature, and is then recycled back. The mixer is initially installed to ensure that once you do the recycling process, there is no significant abruption or abnormality in the process. So this is the overall schematic of ethyl chloride production, and we will be solving this in Aspen HYSYS. For this, we will be selecting the fluid package as Peng-Robinson. The conditions which are given are: temperature is equal to 25 degrees centigrade for feed, pressure is equal to 1 atm, flow rate 100 kg mole per hour, it's a molar flow rate, molar composition given is 0.48 for ethylene, HCl 0.5, nitrogen 0.02, so the sum of it is 1. Then the reactor specification, obviously I have already told you, it's a conversion reactor, and in this conversion reactor, ethylene reacts with HCl to produce ethyl chloride. And the base component will be ethylene, whose 90% conversion is required. We will be using Q heat for this conversion reactor, and the temperature at the outlet or the temperature of the products will not be more than 25 degrees centigrade. The compressor specification is that the outlet pressure is 2100 kilopascal. In the cooler specification, temperature is equal to 20 degrees centigrade, no pressure drop. Then distillation column specification, total number of stages are 7, feed stage is 4. No pressure drop, reflux ratio of 2, and percentage composition of ethyl chloride is 99% in bottoms. Fluid specification is split fraction for purge is 0.1. Valve specification, discharge pressure is 1 atm. And finally, the heater specification is 25 degrees centigrade temperature and no pressure drop. So after going through all this process, let's go to the Aspen HYSYS, build a simulation flow sheet without recycle first, and converge it simultaneously as well. So first we will add the components. The components are ethylene, and we can say ethene because we are searching with full name synonym, ethylene, ethene, then HCl, nitrogen, and ethyl chloride. So C2H5Cl, it's nomenclature. Then in fluid package, click on add and select Peng-Robinson as the thermodynamic property package. Since reaction set is involved, so let's add the reactions over here, add reaction, conversion reaction, adding over here, then giving the required information. Ethylene reacts with HCl to form ethyl chloride. The stoichiometric coefficient for ethylene and HCl will be -1, while for ethyl chloride it will be 1. The base component is ethylene, reaction phase is overall, and the conversion for ethylene should be 90%. And then adding to fluid package, add set to fluid package. Then going to the simulation environment, and we will simulate it step by step. How we will simulate it step by step? That first we need to connect a material stream over here, then a mixer over here, and we will connect it, and it will be like labeled as mixer. Number 1 is this feed stream, number 2 will be the outlet stream, and we will give it specifications as we have given: 25 degrees centigrade, 1 atm, 100 kg mole per hour, and the molar composition as 0.48 for ethylene, 0.54 HCl, and 0.02 for nitrogen. Once after doing it and aligning it a bit, the next one is the conversion reactor. So in reactor, This one is the conversion reactor. We will click it, we will paste it over here. And then the two is inlet stream, three vapor outlet, four liquid outlet, and in the condition we have been given that Q heat needs to be added as well. Then after that, specify the reaction set of conversion. Unknown duty, why? Because we have added a duty. So specifying it as 25 degree centigrade, and accordingly the heat is calculated. Because it's an exothermic reaction, so we are extracting the heat out of it. And we are saying that the products are at the same temperature as that of the feed. So the vapor stream is produced, which contains the flow rate. There is no flow rate in the liquid stream. After that, and if we reduce its size a bit to ensure that all of the streams are here connected as well, and quickly labeling its name as reactor. After that, it is compressed. So applying the compressor over here. And it is K100. We have been given that the number 3 streams goes to here. 5 is the outlet stream. Let's say it is Q102. And in the worksheet, it is 2100 kilopascal as we have been given in the problem statement. And instead of specifying it as Q heat, I will specify it as Q100. Then it is passed through this cooler. And again, in the cooler, we're doing it quickly. 5 is the inlet. 6 is the outlet. And its energy is Q101 because we have labeled energy as Q101, Q100, and then work as Q102. So accordingly, no pressure drop, 2100 kilopascal and 20 degree centigrade. We can also specify the pressure over here as well. That's simply giving zero over here. So one of the thing to do like that. Then, and quickly naming it as cooler, then passing it through this separator. And in the separator, you can see separator 6. Its inlet, 8 its vapor outlet, and 7 its liquid outlet. So you can see it is divided into two parts, liquid and vapor. Now extend it a bit, and 7th stream, as we have seen in our flow sheet, it goes to the distillation column. So in separators, here is the distillation column, which is placed over here. 7 will be its inlet, so labeling it as column 7. Entered this column, the number of stages are 7, feed stage is 4. This one will label it as Q103, this one as Q104. Full reflux has been given, and this one is 9, and bottom liquid outlet, this one is 10. Then going to next 2100 kilopascal and 2100 kilopascal, because no pressure drop is assumed here. Then this optional, and the reflux ratio selected is 2. Click on done, and now since if we go to this monitor tab, we have specified only one specification. However, we have been given the second specification that percentage purity in the bottoms is 99% of ethyl chloride. So what we need to do, we need to untick it, and we have to add a specification, column component fraction, and it's a stream. It's bottom stream, which is labeled as 10 mole fraction 0.99 of ethyl chloride ClC2. And now click on run, and the column has converged. And if we go to this worksheet, as you can see, the bottom stream contains 99% of ethyl chloride, while in other cases, which is the second stream, 38.67% ethylene, HCl, 54.66%, and nitrogen remaining quantity. So once after doing it, we need to combine this 9 and 8, and we have to install a mixer over here, which will be the mixer number 2 for the system. And it will be like number 8 and number 9 to produce number 11. And this will be as mixer 2. After that, we need to split into two fractions, and part of it will be purged, as we have seen in our problem statement and the diagram as well. So click here. This one is the split, and number 11 is split into two fractions, number 13 and number 12. 12 is the purge stream, while 13 will be the recycled. And the per stream split fraction or flow ratio is 0.01. So this is the overall schematic of the process when you have not recycled the number 13 stream. But once you recycle the number 13 stream, then it will be a different phase altogether. So this is the first part of our video where we have done the without recycling part. Now we will add a recycle over here. This recycle is placed over here. And we will move to the other part over here, like clicking and connecting. 13 is connected to here. This out is 14. This one is connected like this. Then it is passed through the valve. This valve is placed over here, and rotating this valve to ensure that there is no problem with it once we have done the connections. So 14 is connected, the outlet is 15, and the pressure drop or the outlet pressure is 180 m as given in the problem. So this one is modified as well, and we can name it as the valve. Then after that, we have to select a heater to heat or to increase its temperature to the feed temperature, which is 25 degrees centigrade. So 15 its inlet, 16 its outlet. This one is Q105. Delta P is 0. We can simply specify over here or here as well. But again, it's up to us. And 25 its outlet. And again, rotating it to ensure that the proper connections are made. And last thing, that we will connect this 16 with mixer. But before doing that, let's relabel it as heater and then opening the mixer and entering the stream number 16 over here. And once 16 is placed over here, there is a warning that recycle RCY1 reached iterations limit without converging. So what we need to do, we need to simply go here in recycle and we need to continue it to increase its number of iterations. So once after the limit, further 4 iterations are required to converge it. And now you can see the system is, or the process is, converged and fully converged. The only issue remains with the internals, so we can further refine it, that we can design the internal system for it. But if we ignore this parameter of sizing or designing an internals, then this is the overall schematic of ethyl chloride production. And if we click on it, now you can see there will be definitely a change in a composition over here. This was earlier, if you remember, around 55.6, it's now 90.68. So that has obviously changed in the system due to the recycling procedure. And you can also look at this heat duties, again the compression duty, the cooler duties, the heater duties before recycling and after recycling to observe the actual time process change due to this recycling phenomena. So that's how the process is simulated. And before going, I will ensure that all of the names are correctly placed over here to avoid any discrepancy in the system. So that's how the process of ethyl chloride production is simulated using Aspen HYSYS. That's it from this video. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.